السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. يا مرحبا، أهلا وسهلا بكم. Welcome for everybody who's watching. Especially people from overseas. يعني overseas يعني خلف البحار. يعني في الشرق إن شاء الله. مرحبا بكم. إن شاء الله we continue in our lectures, our series lectures. إن شاء الله reminding each other. With the deeds and the things that brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Especially we are in the month of Ramadan. We try our best to be the best, inshallah ta'ala. Try your best to be better Muslim. You change. Because if we don't change ourselves in the month of Ramadan, there's a chance. There's no any other month will change us. And if we don't change in this month of Ramadan, we're losers. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, he's a loser. Or she's a loser. Who's that? The one who reached the month of Ramadan and Ramadan came and passed and Allah didn't forgive them. That means what? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them chance to repent and he didn't accept their deeds. And subhanAllah, forgiveness, my brothers and sisters in Islam, is the whole thing is about forgiveness. If Allah forgive us, we are good. We're in a good condition. We are in good place, inshallah. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry, we are in problem. We are in big trouble. Because what? Holding us back, not come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our deeds, the sins that we commit during the day and the night. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins. Allahumma innaka afoon tuhibbu al-afwa fa'afu anna. Oh Allah, you are the oft forgiver. You love to forgive, so please forgive us. We make this dua in Laylatul Qadr, right? And we make it in the month of Ramadan. Why? Because we need the chance. We need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you. Forgive me, inshaAllah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your deeds. So the whole thing about what? About Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how Allah can accept us. If Allah accept us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with us, He will forgive us subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He will guide us. So this is why inshallah we keep reminding each other. I'm myself, wallahi, I need this reminder. You know, we need to keep reminding each other about inshallah how we can come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And last time we mentioned the hadith of Mu'az bin Jabal and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam directed him to a deed that enters him al-Jannah and takes him away from the hellfire. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam told him the pillars of the Islam and he advised him with fasting. He said because it's a protection and he advised him with sadaqah because the sadaqah cool down the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, extinguishes the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like the water with the fire, Allahu Akbar. And then he said to him, praying at night, and to proceed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the end of the hadith, he said to him, what? Amsik alayka hadha. Guard this. And he pointed to his tongue. So Mu'az, he said, أَوَنَحْنُ مُؤَخَذُونَ بِمَا نَقُولُ. Are we going to be held accountable for whatever that we say? Or with whatever that we say? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, سَكَلَتْكَ أُمُّكَ يَا مُعَاذ. وَهَلْ يُكُبُّ النَّاسَ أَوْ يُجَبُّ النَّاسُ عَلَى وُجُوهِهِمْ فِي جَهَنَّمْ إِلَّا حَصَائِدُ أَلْسِنَتِهِمْ. He said to him, and this word, you know, like, is like, you know, like somebody said something funny, something not really, you know, serious, we say this word to them, سَكَلَتْكُ أُمُّكُ, you know. And he said to Mu'az, رضي الله عنه, he said to him, when Mu'az asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, are we going to be held accountable with whatever we say? So he said to him, Nothing will drag people in Jahannam and admit people to in Jahannam except the earning of their tongues. Allahu Akbar. Whatever we say, we have to watch. We have to watch our tongue and we have to watch our words. So this is one from the akhlaq, from the good manners, good conduct of the Muslim. And today we're going to roll in this, inshallah. We're going to roll in the akhlaq because we are in big test. Really, we are in big test. The test of coronavirus. This virus kept people at home. And they came closer to each other. Husband and wife and children, family. And they've been in the same house 24/7. And that's a big test. Now you're going to see who's the real believer. And you're going to see who's the real Muslim. With that test. The test of the man with his wife and his children. This is the reality here. You're going to see, is this real believer or not? And the same thing, the test for the sister with her family. Yeah. Because subhanAllah, especially our schedule here, most of the time that we don't really spend a lot of time with our wives or our families, working and sleeping and, you know, doing other things. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, he been asked, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hadith narrated by Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu. أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه قال سئل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن أكثر ما يدخل الناس الجنة وما يدخل الناس النار فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم أكثر ما يدخل الناس الجنة تقوى الله وحسن الخلق وأكثر ما يدخل الناس النار الأجوفان أكثر ما يدخل الناس النار الأجوفان الفرج والفم سبحان الله. So the translation of this, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrated that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam being asked, what's the most deed or the deed that takes people to al-Jannah, a deed which is will form the foremost deed will enter people to Al-Jannah. He said, Taqwa Allah, the fearing of Allah and good conduct. Fearing of Allah and good manners, good behaviors, good characteristics. Allahu Akbar. Ibn Baz rahmatullah alayhi, he said, Subhanallah, Taqwa Allah min husn al-khuluq, wa husn al-khuluq min Taqwa Allah. Subhanallah, he said, the fearing of Allah, from what? From the good conduct. And the good conduct from the fearing of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they're related to each other, mixed to each other. Taqwa Allah min husn al-khuluq. Taqwa Allah is a part of the good manners, good conduct. Why? Because we have good manners with Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, first. You have good manners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَيْسَ الْبِرَّ أَن تُوَلُّوا وُجُوهَكُمْ قِبَلَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةِ وَالْكِتَابِ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ حتى قال الله سبحانه وتعالى والموفون بعهدهم إذا عاهدوا الله أكبر والصابرون في البأساء والضراء وحين البأس. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى said وآت المال على حبه ذوي القربى واليتامى والمساكين والموفون بعهدهم إذا عاهدوا الله أكبر. So these manners, these good manners, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, righteousness is not to face yourself, to direct your face to east or west in salah. Righteousness is what is iman, to implement and to practice the pillars of iman, of faith. and the pillars of the Islam. Oh. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the righteousness what? To do the iman, to practice the iman and to establish the salah, establish the prayer. See, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said righteousness not to direct your face to east and west. That's what in salah. But the difference between what he said before and after, when you say وَأَقَامَ الصَّلَاةِ, establish the salah. That means you establish the salah with good manners. When you stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you stand with good manners. You deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your salah with good manners. In your dhikr, the remembrance of Allah with good manners. You deal with your family with good manners. You give the charity with good manners. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَقَامَ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتَ الزَّكَاةَ, with good manners. وَالْمُوفُونَ بِعَهْدِهِمْ إِذَا عَاهَدُوا, and they fulfill their promise when they promise people. وَالصَّابِرِينَ فِي الْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَحِينَ الْبَأْسِ, and those who are patient in the time of hardship, time of difficulties and calamities. أولئك الذين أحسنوا وأولئك هم المتقون, those who are the best, those who are do the best, the good doers amongst the Muslims, and those who are really fearful people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. So the manners, akhlaq, is everything. You know, when people, they're visiting us, they're asking us about Islam, we tell them about the pillars of Islam and, you know, the pillars of faith and everything, that now you're Muslim. But you have to make sure, تأكد يا أخي, أن كل هذا, all these pillars of Islam, pillars of Iman, surrounded by the good manners. If, like you guard and you protect these pillars of Islam and pillars of Iman, with good manners. Otherwise, if you leave them, they will lose, they will go. Like a wind, they will leave you. All the pillars of Islam, the pillars of Iman. So this is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said what? أكثر ما يدخل الناس الجنة تقوى الله, the fearing of Allah and good conduct. وأكثر ما يدخل الناس النار, and the most thing that admitted people in the fire, two things, the mouth and the private parts. If you don't protect your mouth, you don't guard your mouth, your tongue, and your private parts, you will be in hell easily. You will be in hell easily. You can disobey Allah every day. And you can do everything that makes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala angry with your tongue and your private parts. And take you what? To hellfire. So al hadith, and this hadith, and the other hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَكْمَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِيمَانًا أَحْسَنُهُمْ أَخْلَاقًا. The most fearful and the perfect believers, amongst the believers, the one who has the best perfect manners. That's the best believer. You see somebody say, I'm a believer, you know, قالت الأعراب آمنا قل لم تؤمنوا. The Arabian before the Bedouin said, we believe. Allah replied to him, he said, what? Say, you didn't believe. ولما يدخل الإيمان في قلوبكم, when this Iman enters into your heart, and you obey Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, and then you say, we believe. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we mentioned, that you have to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and at the same time you guard your good manners, you protect your good manners. You watch your tongue, and you watch your private parts, and you watch how you are dealing with people. Wife and husband, brothers and sisters at the house, children and parents, we are together in the same house. And we are dealing with each other 24 hours. We have to always to think about this. We are Muslims. We are believers. All of us, we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be pleased on us. All of us, we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us in this month of forgiveness. All of us, we need Allah, we need the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine whatever that you do, you know, it can take you away what? From the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It takes you away from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So be amongst the believers. Deal with your parents. With Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he advised us. He said, "Istawsu bin nisa'i khayra." And the other hadith, he said, "Ahsanakum," those who are the best in manners, the best believers, those who are good in conduct. And he said what? "Istawsu bin nisa'i khayra." Take care of women. Take care of your women. Is an advice from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said, خَيَارُكُمْ خَيَارُكُمْ لِأَهْلِ لِنِسَائِهِمْ. From the perfection, that your man is perfect, you want to see the man who is a true believer, go see and how he's dealing with his wife and his family at home. If he's really the good believer, he will deal with him. Because, why? Because they are the closest people to you. They are the closest people to you. And this test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is amana. It's a trust on you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّهُنَّ عَوَانٌ لَكُمْ. Allah send them to you is blessing and mercy and to help you in your life. And to protect you in the same time. It's a trust, amana. How did you take them with the promise, with the oath, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? على كتاب الله زوجتك على كتاب الله وسنة محمد وسنة نبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. I married you based on the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's what we say in the marriage contract, right? It's an oath. That you establish the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم with this sister. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, استوصوا بالنساء خيرا. فإنهن خلقن من ضلع أعوج وأعوج الضلع علاه. He said, keep hold or take care of the woman always in goodness. Be good with the woman. Because they have been created from what? Curved rib. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and always I remind the brothers when they get married with this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? Ya ayyuhan nas ittaqu rabbakum alladhi khalaqakum min nafsin wahida wa khalaqa minha zawjaha wa bassa minhuma rijalan kathiran wa nisaa wa ittaqullaha alladhi tasaaluna bihi wal arham. Fear Allah, fear Allah, fear Allah. In this ayah. And Allah reminding us that He created you from a single self, Adam, and from him He created His maid, His wife, Hawa alayhis. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He said what? Hawa has been created from the rib of Adam. Allah created Hawa from the rib of Adam. And subhanAllah, this rib is very sensitive. And the women are very sensitive too. And it's very important. The rib is a protection, it's a shield. You know what's under the ribs? Our livers, our heart, and the most sensitive and very weak. We can say very weak and very sensitive. It's easy. If you cut any one of them, you'll die. All these veins inside the closer to the heart and the heart, all this being protected by our ribs. Sisters are protection for us. Subhanallah. And they've been created from this rib. And the rib is very sensitive like them. Allahu Akbar. If you break this rib, you're going to be in pain for a while. And it's not easy to heal. It takes time. It takes time for this rib to heal. That's why you see these fighters, what they guard. They guard their ribs. Because what? If they get hit over here, they can lose their breath. They can, you know, die, or they can lose the game easily. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us these sisters amana. We should take care of them and then be created from our ribs. We should take care of them like we take care of our own ribs. Because if we break them like we break our ribs, it's not easy. You break her heart, you break the woman, that's it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you try to fix it, you will break it. Like if you try hardly to fix this curved rib, you will break it. And then if you leave it like that, but you have to be patient and you have to be nice, you be gentle, give them a time, give the sister a time to change. They will be better than us. So this why this one of the good manners. A lot of brothers, they're calling me, subhanAllah, they're complaining from their wives. And one brother is complaining from his own mom. He was complaining from his mom. Why? Because this, subhanAllah, this coronavirus makes people to discover a lot of things amongst each other, between each other. Especially when we come to husband. And some people, you know, we can talk about positive things too, you know. Some brothers, mashallah, they've been in worship, remembering Allah, stay away from all these devices and things, and they just keep remembering Allah and reading the Quran and things. He said, subhanAllah, I've never been closer to my wife and my children like this time, especially in the time of Ramadan. Subhanallah. He said, I feel like I'm in Jannah. My house is Jannah. Yeah. Why? Because they remember of Allah. I told them, just keep remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't waste your time. Keep teaching them good things. They can listen. But you have to be a role model for them. You have yourself, you have to be a role model. And you have to act good. You have to be a good believer. They will see you, mashallah. We didn't know that our father like that, mashallah. He's so kind, so nice, so patient, friendly, mashallah. So this is the positive thing, but the negative thing, subhanAllah, fighting, shaitan is there. The shaitan is there. Why? Because the house is full with what? With the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is no any advice, there is no any good advice. You know, they don't sit with each other like this, discuss all the issues with good manners, good conduct. That's what we need, especially in the month of Ramadan. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لَيَبْلُغُ الْمُؤْمِنِ دَرَجَةُ الصَّائِمُ وَالْقَائِمُ. The believer can reach the level of those who are fasting and praying at night with his good characters. With the good characters, you reach that level. Imagine in Ramadan, you recite the Quran, you have Allah multiply your reward for you. You are fasting, Allahu Akbar. How tremendous, how big reward you will receive from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Praying at night, you have, mashallah, you are amongst the people of closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are the most people close and most people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them. And then, subhanAllah, you have good characters, good manners. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the mu'min, the believer, he will reach the level of those people who are praying and fasting if his characters are good or her characters are good. Yeah. So we need to be gentle, we need to be nice. Smile to all of them. Smile and say, mashallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the best sadaqah, the food that you put in the mouth of your wife. That's the best sadaqah. Period. So the best sadaqah, that's the highest sadaqah, the highest reward of sadaqah. Don't belittle any good deed. Don't look down to any good deed. Even to smile in the face of your wife. Allahu Akbar. And make her smile. Make your wife smile. Make them smile. SubhanAllah. Some people, they go to the masjid, they go outside, mashallah, they're so nice, so sweet, friendly with everybody. But when they enter the house, you see them, they are different. Allahu Akbar. He treat his wife like he's a lion or a tiger or something else. Like kind of beasts. So this is why we have to watch our way And we have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know what? Always you think, this sister is blessing to me from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you always you think about that, Allahu Akbar. Even if you see a lot of wrong things of how you're going to forgive. Why? Because he looked to her as a barakah, blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unto you. And then the sister, you look to your husband too, mashallah. This brother is a blessing for me. Wow. It's a blessing for me. And when you look to this, Allahu Akbar. When you look to this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you always to have the barakah, the blessings in your, you know. That's the whole thing about the barakah. If you lost the barakah in your family, Allahu Akbar, you lost everything. This is why the dua, when we marry somebody, what do we say? Barakallahu lakuma wa baraka alaykuma wa jama'a baynakuma fil khayr. May Allah bless you and bestow His blessings upon you and gather between you in good always, all the time, gather between you in good. So who is that good? There is nothing better than the Quran and the Sunnah. There is nothing better than the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the khayr. That's the khayr, that's the goodness of this world, the life, as well in the hereafter. And then you look to this brother like he's your footstep to Al-Jannah. Try to learn from him, you know, and to encourage him to go and study so he can come and teach. And the same thing, you look to this sister like your step to Al-Jannah. She's protecting you not to fall in any haram, not to look to any other one. And she's taking care of your all your desires, mashallah. Plus that, she's taking care of your service. And she's taking care of your children if you have children. Always you look to these good things. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? If you hate something or you dislike something on them, perhaps you will find a lot of good on them. Be patient with them. Be patient with your women. So this is an advice for the sisters too, you know. Try to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with your good manners with your husband. Be nice and be gentle. No argue. That's your way to Al-Jannah. Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أَنَا زَغِيمٌ بِبَيْتٍ فِي رَبَضِ الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ تَرَكَ الْمِرَاءَ وَإِنْ كَانَ مُحِقًّا وببيت في وسط الجنة لمن ترك الكذب وإن كان مازحا وببيت في أعلى الجنة لمن حسن خلقه. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, I'm in charge, guaranteed a house in the surrounding of the Jannah, house around the Jannah for someone who left arguing, even he's true. If he isn't true, he's right. But he left the arguing for the sake of not to be, you know, to argue. He will have that house around the Jannah. And in the I'm in charge. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, well, I'm in charge. Like I guaranteed a house in the middle of Al-Jannah. For someone, stay away from what? Lies. Lying. Wow. You want your behaviors and your marriage to be excellent? Stay away from lying. And that's your way to Al-Jannah. مَا يَزَالُ الرَّجُلُ يَصْدُقُ وَيَتَحَرَّ الصِّدْقَ حَتَّى يُكْتَبُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ صِدِّيقًا وَإِنَّ الصِّدْقَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْبِرِّ وَإِنَّ الْبِرَّ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you see the one who's what? Who's always truthful and seeks the ways of truthful. He tries his best or her best to be truthful with Allah, with people, and with themselves. They try to be truthful and seeking that way of truthfulness until will be written on the side of Allah, Siddiq. You know, Siddiq. The one who really truthful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, Siddiq in Jannah, that will be in the level after. النبيين والصديقين. After the Nabiyeen, the Siddiqeen will be with them. And subhanallah, for us, the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we will be with Rasulullah, sitting with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Did Rasulullah said that? Yes, he said that. Same thing that brings us closer to Rasulullah, and we'll be with him in Jannah, his companions in Jannah. I will go to mention this hadith. It's a proof from Rasulullah. He said it with his own words. So he said, I'm in charge of one in the house, or I'm guaranteed a house in the middle of Al-Jannah for someone who stay away from lies. Even he's joking. Some people, they do a lot of jokes, but it's lies. It's lying. Subhanallah. That's going to be considered, going to count in your pay as a bad deed, as a liar, 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 until you'll be written on the side of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a liar. Lies, always that takes you to what? To do evil deeds. Now you're saying, you know, wrong and or lying or not correct statements, and then you're going to do not correct deeds, incorrect deeds, and then you fall in what? In committing sins. فإن الكذب يهدي إلى الفجور. كذب, the lying leads you to what? To evil, bad deeds. And evil, bad deeds leads you to the hellfire. But the opposite, truthfulness leads you to what? To good deeds. You try to be truthful with Allah, with people, with everybody. Allah will direct you and Allah will guide you to do a lot of good deeds. وَالْبِرِّ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. And righteousness leads you to what? To the paradise. So this is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I'm in charge of in the house in the middle of Al-Jannah for someone, stay away from lies. Even he's joking. وَأَنَا زَعِيمٌ بِبَيْتٍ فِي أَعْلَى الْجَنَّةِ. And I'm in charge of a house and the highest of Al-Jannah, of paradise. That means highest, who's the highest in paradise? أَعْلَى الْيِينَ with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لِمَنْ حَسُنَ خُلُقُهُ. The one who has good characters, the one who has good conduct. I'm in charge of that house. You want to be with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do you want to be closer to him, or you want to be with him in Jannah? Listen to this. And Jabir radiallahu anhuma. Jabir ibn Abdullah, because what? Jabir and his father, both of them are Ansar, and both of them are Muslims. Jabir radiallahu anhuma. He said what? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أحبكم إلي وأقربكم مني مجلسا يوم القيامة أحاسنكم أخلاقا. The dearest one to you and the most closer one to me on Majlis. Majlis, that means sittings. The one who will sit next to me in Jannah, the closest one to me, أحسنكم أخلاقا. The one who has best manners, best conduct, Allahu Akbar, best behaviors, the good manners. Good manners with who? Good manners with believers, with non-believers. Good manners, the best with your wives, with your, you know, especially with this test of coronavirus. You stay at home, always you have to think about this. And read this, all these hadiths, well, is in Bukhari and Muslim at Tirmidhi, and you can find them in Riyadh al-Salihin. Yeah. Bring that Quran, bring that Mus'haf of the Quran, take it and try to read it, inshallah. Being translated with different languages. Try to read it with your family, with your wives. Allah will bring the nur, light into your house. The angels will come and sit into your house. Tranquility will descend upon your house, descend upon you. Rahmah will pass through, the mercy of Allah will pass through you. And Allah will mention you in the Beda gathering. Allahu Akbar. Every day we should have halaqa of Quran with our wives, with our children. Every day we should have that and read from Riyadh al-Salihin, and read from the book of Riyadh al-Salihin some hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Different languages. And then you give the children, train them, let them read the hadith. Train them, let them read Quran. Train them, let them lead the Salah. Allahu Akbar. So all these were these the good deeds. But the best thing that they want somebody to listen to you and love you, you have to have good manners. Because if somebody loves you, he will listen to you. And somebody doesn't love you, he's not going to listen to you. That's how it is. Yeah. Your wife, your children, they love you because of your good manners, because you're so nice with them. They will listen to you and you can give them da'wah. You can teach them and you can do a lot of things. But if they don't listen to you, you know, nobody likes somebody to shout on them. Do you like somebody to shout on you or, you know, look down to you or curse you? No. So this is why we have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if we need that nur, the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to descend upon us. If we need to change, this is the key. We have to read a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And to reach that level of righteousness, same thing. You know, first thing you have to do your salah, your dhikr, your ibadah, and everything, and try to fulfill the rights of your family. Wallahi, subhanallah, one brother, he was telling me like amazing things, subhanallah. You know, he said, I was closer to my wife. I never been closer to my wife like this. Especially until I start telling her about my other wife. He said, we've been very close until I start telling you about my other wife. Allahu Akbar. How closer they are. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Yeah. And some brothers, mashallah, they've been blessed because they have 3-4 wives, mashallah, or 2 wives. Yeah. With this corona, you change. Like so one day you are here, one day you're changing the environment. But how about the sisters? Subhanallah. So that's why they need you to be the best for them, to make them enjoy you, your characters, your you know, they make them miss you. You know, make your family to miss you when you are not there. Like they are missing something very important. Some sisters, subhanAllah, they hope and they wish if their husbands, they don't come home. They wish if they don't come home at all. Imagine now the coronavirus put them with you inside the house. You have to be patient. And the brother, you have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and this sister. That solves all the problem. Don't be loud. Don't always try to be loud. Loud. You know, some brothers, mashallah, they're always loud with their when you see them, mashallah, they're humble in the masjid. Salaamu alaikum, wa alaikum as-salam, big smile, mashallah. When they go home, that face will change. And then they will be loud. And then just ordering, commanding, like chief of an army or something. And then you want this sister, subhanallah, miskina. She's, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help this sister. But you're going to lose a lot of rewards. You're going to bring the shaitan inside the house with you. Because you are acting the action of what? Shaitan. You're not humbling yourself. Arrogant, proud. And then what? Nobody's going to listen to you. You cannot. You're going to be... More you are angry and more you're loud, more you are weaker. More you are weaker and more you are, you know, you're down. But more you're humble, nice. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he controlled the love, he controlled the hearts of the Sahaba. With what? Kindness. Allahu Akbar. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, وَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَظًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ فَاعْفُ عَنْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ. He said that out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you became what? Lenient and gentle with them. Lenient and gentle with them. But if you are tough and harsh, you have tough and harsh heart with them, they will run away from you. Nobody is going to be around you. But subhanAllah, you see these Sahaba, they used to miss Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the extent that one of them, he's with his wife at home, crying, tearing. Why are you crying? He said, I miss my beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I want to go and see Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he goes to the masjid and he sees Prophet Muhammad, he starts crying again. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, why are you crying? He said, Ya Rasulullah, I miss. I remember that if we die, and we go to be in Jannah, you're going to be in the higher level, and I don't know where I'm going to be at. I don't know where I'm going to be. I'm not going to see you anymore. Subhanallah. He's thinking about what? Even after they die, he doesn't want to be away. He wants to be closer to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because he has the best manners. Allah perfected his characteristic. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him Sayyid al-Anbiya wal-Mursaleen. He is the chief and the master of all the Anbiya and the Mursaleen, the Imam. And he's the best man, period, in the face of the earth. Allahu Akbar, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he's saying all these words. He's saying these words and he's teaching us. Why? Because he's the best. This is why he said what? خياركم خياركم لأهلي. The best among you, those who are the best with their families. And I'm the best one with my families. SubhanAllah. He's speaking the truth and he's very sure that he's the best one with his family. Imagine, ya akhi, subhanAllah, imagine. Aisha radiallahu anha, she has a plate full with food and she gets cracked that, or she's crouched and threw it away in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his people. Because of jealousy, the food came from the other house. Yeah, I think the story, the food that came from other house, Aisha radiallahu anha, she took it and she threw it. Did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, are you divorced? Go to your house? Or did he took a stick on, you know, Ibiza? Or did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smiled? Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. He smiled and he said, gharat ummakum, Allahu Akbar. He smiled and he said, look at your mother. She became jealous. Mother of the believer, she became jealous. And he said to her, that's from the shaitan. She said, do I have shaitan in me? She said to her, yes, everybody has the shaitan. Running like the blood on our veins. Everybody, except me, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I called my shaitan and I gave him that one. He became Muslim. That's the characteristic of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his family. And a lot of examples, a lot of things, how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to be kind with all these wives and gentle. My brother, if you are not really a man and you are not really strong and you can control your anger, don't marry two or three, because you are going to lose your side of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are not a true believer and you think you are not going to be a just and you are not really can take care of this responsibility, you should not do so. Some brothers get two and three, and mashallah, and he's lion with all of them. He's a lion here and tiger there, and different creature and the other one, with the other one. So this is why we have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shaitan always in the houses. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the shayateen will stay in the house. When the man come and enter his house, say, Bismillah, Assalamu Alaikum. The shayateen, what they will say? They said, now you don't have no any time to spend it in this house. You have to leave. Why? Because he came with Assalamu Alaikum wa rahmatullah, with a smile to the family. Yeah, some people, they enter the house, they don't even give salam. Why? Because they see their wives every day. See the children every day. Why do you have to give salam too much? That's going to, you know, to decrease my manship. I have, subhanAllah, action of the shaitan. You have to say assalamu alaikum with a smile, and you have to be gentle. You tell your wife, I love you. You tell your children, I love you. you know, you hug them and you kiss them and all these things. Break the back of the shaitan. The shaitan will get very angry and is going to lose a lot. But imagine you came and you support the shaitan against with your family with these bad manners. And the shayateen, when you serve the food and you say Bismillah, Rasulullah said the shaitan will say, you don't have any food here in this house. Now you have to leave. And imagine if you recite Surah Al-Baqarah in the house, especially in the month of Ramadan, or recite the Quran. No way for the shaitan to enter your house. Some people, they say, you say Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the shayateen will be chained, shackled. They are not there anymore. And what you guys talking about? You know. So the correct and the right meaning of that, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said the shayateen. We talked about this before and we explained it. The giant one among the jinn, the giant ones, the gangsters amongst them, they will be shackled and they will be chained. And they don't have no way to come. But there's a shayateen with you. There's the little ones in the house. Those who are whispering onto you. And those who are draining in your blood, like in your veins, like a blood, with they mixing with you. Some people, they be possessed literally with jinn and shayateen. All these will be remain with you. Because some of the jinns and the shayateen, they will be what? They will be tied it with magic and some things that in the body of the person. This person became like what? Like possessed with the jinn and the shayateen. Still will be remain there. Yeah. And some people themselves, they are shayateen in Ramadan. Person who's really loud, who's fasting, praying, but his manners are really bad. Yeah. Subhanallah, ya akhi, subhanallah, we see this here in our neighbors, in our area over here, subhanallah. This Ramadan changed a lot of, everything is there, subhanallah. So this will always remind, remember Allah and you do good deeds and watch your behaviors, your manners, inshallah, you will be a true slave of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And do that with full heart and fearing of Allah. We talk about fearing. People, they don't even, subhanAllah, some people, they don't feel that. They don't know, because they don't experience that. Because just Muslim. Fashioned Muslim. Show off Muslim, subhanAllah. But look to the believers, the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How Allah described them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون الذين يقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون أولئك هم المؤمنون حقا الله أكبر مؤمنون حقا, the true faithful believers. These are the true believers. Who's there? Who's there? Allah. Who's there? These people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what he said? إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Verily the believers, those when Allah's name mentioned, their heart will be filled with fearing. Their heart will be filled. Just they hear the name of Allah. Hear the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching over them. And they remember the anger of Allah in the day of judgment. They remember everything. The power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They remember what Allah said in the Quran. And then when you recite the Quran on them, they listen to the Quran, that increases them in iman. Zadatuhum imana. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. And they are fully relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fully rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fully, they have full trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقَّى. He said, الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ. Those who establish the salah. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ And those who always spend from whatever that has been given from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, been provided from Allah, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقَّ Those are the true believers. So this Quran, all these reminders supposed to do something with your iman, especially in the month of Ramadan. Why our iman will go higher, higher, higher in the month of Ramadan? Or some of us, the iman will go higher. Some of us, the iman will be same level, or some may be down. Why? Based off our, how we are closer to Allah with our fasting, with our sincerity, with our deeds with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the fearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how we best with our conduct. How we are best with our behaviors and manners. That brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فالمؤمن ينبغي أن يحسن خلقه يقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم البر حسن الخلق The believer suppose what? To fix his manners and to train yourself for that. Everything needs training. You train yourself. The best thing that you fix your manners, you forgive. That's the hardest thing and that's the best. You forgive. You sleep, when you go to bed, you make sure that you forgive everybody. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting in the masjid and he said, may I tell you about someone from amongst the dwellers of the Jannah will enter the masjid right now? Boom, a man came, he has his beard is wet with the water because he just made wudu and he came. Subhanallah, the sahaba looked to him. And the other day he said to him, may I tell you about a man amongst the dwellers of Al-Jannah who's walking with us in this world of life, amongst the dwellers of Al-Jannah will enter right now? A man enters, the same one enters the masjid again. The Sahaba said, wow, this person is... And then the other day he said, may I tell you about a man amongst the dwellers of Al-Jannah will enter the masjid right now? And the same man, he came again. Allahu Akbar. Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, he was there. He looked at this man, he said, no. I have to go and look. I have to chase this man and see what he's doing. Like three times. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he's amongst the dwellers of the Jannah and he enters. Allahu Akbar. This man is... So he went to him and he said to him, you know what, I have problems and I don't have place. Can I spend a night with you? He said to him, okay. Bismillah. So he slept. You know, he went and he prepared his bed and, you know, he said, I was watching this man, what he's doing. So he stayed with him for 3 days, I think, and then he was watching him, what he's doing. He said when he sleeps, he doesn't do much like what we do. Like we see him stand and just pray his witr and go to sleep. He doesn't pray the whole night. But whatever he's sleeping and he moved, he remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine Abdullah ibn Amr, his guest, he went here to watch this man, what he's doing. This is how these people like care, really care about Jannah. And he said, I see him like praying like us and fasting like us. And he's doing normal deeds. I said, subhanallah, he's doing the same thing like what we do, or maybe less. So he asked him, he said to him, you know what? I didn't have no any problem. But Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he pointed on you three times. He said, you are among the people of Al-Jannah. What do you do? He said, I don't do much. But before I go to sleep, I make sure that I forgive everybody. Allah, I make sure that I empty my heart from any hatred, from any problem, and I forgive everybody. Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, he said to him, that's it. That's what enters al-Jannah. And it's difficult for a lot of us, most of us, it's difficult for them to do that. Allahu Akbar. So the best thing that you do, you forgive during the day and the night. Forgive people. You know, practice this while you are fasting. فإن سابه أحد أو شاتم قال اللهم إني صائم أو قال إني صائم. Somebody came and argue with you, fighting with you, or cursing you, or whatever. You look to them, you say, Allahumma inni sa'im. And you say, oh, well, I'm fasting. I don't want no problems with nobody. It's a training. That's you be in that level. And after Ramadan, that's going to be your manners. Ya Allah, I'm mu'min. I'm a believer. I'm Muslim. I can't go reply back. They say F words, they have to say mother F words. If they say something, I have to say something worse. That's manhood, right? They punch, I have to show them my guard, I have to show them my box. All this shaitan, al-iyaz billah. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. And those who forgives people. وَالصَّابِرِينَ, those who are patient in the time of hardship and the test and difficulty. And I will finish with this, I will end with this, inshallah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is the final hadith we're going to mention for today. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَيْسَ الْقَوِيُّ بِالصُّرْعَةِ وَإِنَّمَا الْقَوِيُّ مَنْ يَمْلِكْ نَفْسَهُ عَنْدَ الْغَضَبِ وَلَيْسَ الشَّدِيدُ بِالصُّرْعَةِ. In the other narration. The strongest, the powerful one, the strongest one, not the one who wins in wrestling. The strongest and the powerful one, the one who controls himself in the time of anger. Controls himself in the time of anger. And the best amongst you, the one who best with his family. And Rasulullah is the best with his family. You, the best amongst you, the one who is best with their wives. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to pass this test. The test of this period right now. The situations that we are in. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to pass the greater test, the test of the dunya. All this dunya, Allah is testing us every day to see who's the true believer and who's the munafiq, he's the hypocrite. And all these things that will clarify who's the true believer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and who's more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and who's far away from Allah and just Muslim by name. Muslim by their name. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as'al Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-huda wa al-tuqa wa al-afaf wa al-ghina. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guidance and fear. Taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst the dwellers of the Jannah. Ameen. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.